So the agenda for today is creating purchase order. Okay. In our previous class, we discussed about how to create the requisition and what are the requisition tables, right? And we developed some queries and we created concurrent programs for those procedures, right? Like show requisition summary and show requisition details. In each operating unit, what are the requisitions out there along with their status and type, we have developed a program to see the summary. And also we developed another program that is to show the requisition details technically. From the navigation side, you all know that how to create the requisition and what are the backend tables. So the agenda for today is creating a purchase order. Okay. The order is not like that. It's a final form that we are going to send it to the supplier, where the supplier is going to send the material. Okay, after discussion with the quotation plan, everything, the purchase order is created. So to create a purchase order, there are two options. You can create the purchase order directly, but if you are creating a requisition, that means in the business, if they are creating a requisition, they will go with the auto create option. There is an option called auto create. In the purchasing responsibility, what we have to do is auto create option is there. So this is the navigation. You can refer this document to create the purchase orders. Okay. So in the purchasing vision operations responsibility, click on auto create. We have to click on auto create to create the purchase order. Why we have to click on auto create? There are two options. Purchase orders is there and auto create is there. Basically, the auto create option will help you to pull all the data from the requisition. Whatever values you entered in the requisition, right? So everything will be pulled into this form. Purchase order means it won't take anything from the requisition. You have to enter everything manually. You need to enter everything manually. That means again, item name, item number, quantity, price, everything you have to enter. So whatever the details you entered already in the requisition, those are not populated or those are not carried here. But auto create means you can connect, you can link with the requisition and you can get everything from the requisition. You no need to re-enter the values, the item that you chose and quantity, price, all those values will be displayed from the requisition directly. So to create a purchase order, if the requisition is available, then we have to go to auto create. Okay, so we have to click on auto create. Then next, this screen will be open. Second screen is this. We need to click on, we need to enter the requisition number. Remove all the values. If you have any values, just remove all the values. Enter the requisition number that is created. And after that, click on find. See, the requisition information is displayed. What is the item, category, item description, everything is displayed. Just you need to check this box. And here we have options, create, standard PO and default. Here, this is the document type, standard PO. There are different types of purchase order like standard PO, blanket PO and planned PO, etc. So based on the agreement between the vendor and vendee, we have to choose. But standard PO is an option which you can create, which you can use at any time. Anytime the PO can be created, okay? And it can be sent to the supplier. Planned PO means there is an agreement, okay? We have to plan it, like in the 6 months or in this quarter, only these items can be purchased from the supplier. Our supplier has an agreement that supplier can deliver these items and with this much quantity. There's a blanket PO that doesn't have any restrictions. Anytime we can do it. But It's an agreement. Whatever you order, they will have to deliver. Standard PO is like anytime you can create the PO, but make sure the supplier is able to deliver that. There is no agreement, but we have to check, okay, supplier can is he has the capability to deliver it. Once that requisition approval means everything is done. So standard PO, create automatic. Why this automatic option is selected here is because we are creating the purchase order based on the requisition. Okay, based on the requisition that purchase order is creating. So that's why we have to click on the automatic button. So all the supplier details will be provided here. No need to enter anything, just simply click on create. So you'll get all the details. This is the PO form. This is the purchase order form. Okay, auto create purchase order. So PO number, supplier, supplier site, ship to, bill to, buyer, status. Status is now incomplete status because this is a new purchase order is created. This is the PO number. Okay, this is the PO number. And this is the item and category, description, quantity, price, all are populated. Now we have to go to the shipments. View the shipment screen to change the match approval level. Okay. After the requisition is entered, when you click on the auto create option, this form is open. This form is open. And this is the form where you have all the PO details. Okay. Like PO number, supplier number, ship to location, bill to location, the material has to ship to which location. Okay. All those details you have here. Match approval level we need to select in the shipment. This is the shipment screen. Shipment form. Click here. So shipment form is open. In that, you need to select match approval level. So receipt close and invoice close is there, right? This is nothing but the tolerance. If any variance, okay, how much you can accept. Okay, so that we have to give. For example, 10% means there will be a 10% variance. Invoice close also, there will be 10%. If you give 5%, with the 5%, you can close this. Match approval should be two-way. Two-way means it is the PO quantity and received quantity is matching or not, that will check. Okay, there are multiple options like two-way, three-way, and four-way. Two-way, generally most of the companies will follow two-way, so you can change it to three-way also. That means here the purchase order that is created with order quantity, for example, 5, and received quantity is matching or not. And after that, after you received, based on the PO, an invoice can be created. Or you can also create an invoice based on the receipt also. Receipt means after the goods are received, and receipt will be created. Based on that receipt also, like invoice can be created. So that option can be selected. But most of them will choose the PO. So match approval level is two-way, and choose the invoice match option as PO. Okay. And receiving controls, make sure that routing is made as direct routing. Here we need to select receipt routing as direct delivery, and these can be changed, receipt date, days early, 5 days late, etc. So this is something like for example, the PO order date, okay, they committed on suppose December 10th. So if they deliver 5 days earlier or 2 days earlier, that we have to mention. If they deliver before the delivery date, what will be the action? Either warning or reject. That action we have to give here. So similarly, receipt also. The received quantity, is there any mismatch in the received quantity? What will be the action? Okay, so that all business users will take care of it. No technical consultant will involve in that. So don't worry about it. But yeah, we should have an idea about it. And this one also they will send. This is complete end user job. It's whatever the screens you are seeing, right? That's end user job. But technical consultant should know the how to go to the PO form and how to check all the tables. Save and submit for approval. Click OK, save and submit for approval. This option will be submit for approval. Click OK. Once that is done, you can see the message as approved here. Okay, this is a PO and this is approved. So PO is approved. So just you can take the note of the PO number. This is all about how to create a PO. It's very simple. Okay. So the PO form, to open the PO form, you have to go to the auto create option. So you can take this as a small exercise and you can start developing the PO. If you have any questions, then you can discuss with me. So again, I'll repeat the questions before going into the technical part. I mean, tables and columns. So just let me explain again. So what you have to do, first the requisition has to be created. After that, you have to go to the purchasing responsibility, click on auto create. Because we are creating the purchase order based on the requisition. Whenever you're creating a purchase order based on the requisition, you have to go to auto create option. Okay. And after this auto create, this form will open. Enter the requisition. This requisition you have to enter. After this requisition is entered, click on fine. Okay, next click on automatic as shown in the above figure to create the purchase order. This one. Okay, so auto create we have to choose. Next, just click on create. CPO is open. But now it is in incomplete status. Shipment information, if you want to see, just go to the shipments. Choose to match approval level, either two-way or three-way, depends on the business. They will sell it. Okay. And receiving control, choose this direct delivery, click save, and submit for approval. Submit for approval. Then check the PO is approved. Okay. So that is all about how to create a purchase order. Now, this is where the developer will involve in the most of the reports or forms when you are developing our procedures, purchase tables or purchase order tables. So there are different tables out there, purchase PO headers all. Okay, this is the main table. When the PO is created, this is a header part. So what is the header part here? If you go to the PO form, right, this is a PO form. Okay, this is our PO form. This portion is called header part. This is called header part. So if you go to help and record history, you can see that the header part you can see. This is called header part from here to here. This portion. This is a separate block. So in this operating unit, PO number, supplier, ship to, buyer, and create a date, that is nothing but creation date. Type, what is the type of purchase order? Site, the supplier address. This material has to go to which location, that's a ship to. And bill has to go to bill to. So this could be different also. The material has to ship to a different place and bill has to go to ship a different place. Okay, so the bill to location and ship to location we have to pull. And buyer, status, authorization status, and currency, contact, all these details you can get it. Only the challenge is this amount won't be available in the table. So for that we have to do some conditions. We have to join with this table and get the amount from here, because this price into quantity we have to multiply. Fine. So this is the header table. Okay, and this table has these columns, PO headers are. So in this PO header ID, you will have an header ID, agent ID. The agent ID, okay, agent ID is here. If you look at this form, buyer is there, right? That's the agent ID. The buyer is nothing but what here? Agent ID. Okay. And this agent ID, you have to join to the Parar people F, get the full name with the person ID. Person ID we need to join. Okay, person ID is nothing but what? Agent ID. In the table you will see the agent ID. So we have to join with the person ID and get the name. Okay, that's our agent name, you can get it. So, and what else is there? PO number. This PO number, okay, let's start from here. PO number. This PO number will have a column called segment one. This is a PO number. You need to take the column called segment one from the pivot address all table. Okay. And type. Okay, we'll go like this. Type, but standard per charge is there, right? The type is this. Type lookup code. This is a pivot type. Authorization status. This is status. This is status. Approved. The status you can get it from here. Authorization. Org ID, operating unit. What is the operating unit? This one. Operating unit. So we got operating unit, PO number, type, and status, right? Supplier. Vendor ID. This is a supplier. So this vendor ID you have to join to the AP suppliers table with vendor ID. Get vendor name. To know the vendor name, the vendor ID has to ship to. Vendor ID has to join to the vendor ID in AP supplier state. Get the vendor name. Okay. And site, vendor site ID. This site ID is there, right? This site ID also you can join to the vendor site ID here. Vendor site ID to vendor site ID in AP supplier sites all. Okay, or you can join to the vendor ID to vendor ID and get the vendor site ID. But one vendor can have multiple sites. Okay, so one supplier can have multiple sites. That's the case. We have to join with the site ID. And ship to location, bill to location. These IDs you can pull it directly. And there is a table called HR locations. You can join to that table also. HR locations is one more table is there. So you can join to that table. HR_locations_all. Okay. So this is the table for location. Location details you can get it from location table. So in this you have columns. Location ID. Location ID you have and location code you have and other details like address 1 and address 2, the like city, zip, all those details you can get from here. Okay, this is the location table. So this location ID you can map with the location IDs here. Ship to location ID and build to location IDs you can map with this. So you can join this and so that's a PO headers hall table. Segment one, PO number, bill to location, ship to location, and vendor site ID, vendor ID, terms ID. Terms ID is like if you wanted to know the terms of the payment after 30 days or immediately, so and so details you can get it from the term ID. There's a table called AP terms. You can join with the term ID here. Okay, so term ID, these are all the tables, this is the table and these are all the columns in the purchase header. Okay, you have everything. PO number, that's a segment one. This is org ID and supplier is vendor ID, ship to location, buyer is agent ID, creation date created by, those are all covered, two columns. Type, type lookup code, site, that is vendor site ID is there, right? That one. Build to location ID, status, authorization status. Currency, you can take it directly. There's a currency code is there, so that you can use it directly. Okay, in the table, you can check that. Total amount won't be there. Total amount will not be there. We have to take it manually. Okay, but from the form, you can see the total amount, but in the backend, it won't be available. Right, after the PO is, PO header information you captured, go to the PO lines. These are lines. So in the PO lines, these are the columns. This is the relation between these two, PO headers and PO lines table. Header ID to header ID. And next, PO line ID, item ID, quantity, price. Item ID, this item ID is what? It's an inventory item ID. Okay, it's an inventory item ID. MPL items B to get the inventory item name. Okay, inventory item ID in MPL system items B. Quantity price you can take it directly. Okay, item. Item name will be available in the form, but item ID is available in the table. So item ID we have to join to the inventory item ID in MTL system items B. And shipments, the shipment information is in PO line locations all time. That shipments we click right, so that information you can get it from this table. Line location ID, PO line ID, PO header ID, ship to location ID, and quantity received. And if you want the accounting details, you can go to the PO distribution salt table. PO distribution salt table will have PO distribution ID, PO address ID, PO line ID, requisition distribution ID, and deliver to location ID, setup box ID, code combination ID. So you all know this, right? Setup box ID where to join, code combination ID where to join. And other tables, suppliers tables is AP suppliers. All supplier sites or table is this, and supplier contacts details can get it from here. All employees table, you can get it from Paral PPLF. Okay, or you can say all buyers. And locations, you can get it from here. You can see this IDs you can join. It's very simple. Personal ID, except the personal ID, all columns are matching, like vendor ID, vendor ID, vendor site ID, vendor site ID, and term ID, term ID. Okay. Location ID, location ID, that will be matched. Only for the person ID, we have to join with the agent ID. That's a buyer to get the person details. Okay, so what is the challenge is here? When you create a purchase order, you wanted to know the purchase order is created based on which requisition. Okay, the purchase order is created based on which requisition that we want to do. So for that, what we have to do is, if you look at this table, this PO distribution ID is the distribution ID for the purchase order distributions. Okay, so purchase order distributions. There is another column called requisition distribution ID is there, right? This requisition distribution ID is the actual requisition distribution ID. So we have to join this to the distribution ID in PO requisition distribution solve. PO requisition distribution solve. And from here, you can get the PO requisition lines table. From here, you need to go to the distribution ID. You have to go to the requisition headers and get the requisition number. It is a little bit confusing, right? So what you have to do is, okay, let me explain that. here this is the auto create option. When you're creating the purchase order, you have to go to auto create. So it is giving some error. I'll check this. Okay, but all other steps are mentioned in the documents. So now coming to the tables. Okay, so here first table, header table, select star from PO underscore headers underscore all. You can take recently created POs, order by creation date descending. Okay, recently purchased orders you can take. For example, this one. What is a PO? What is a segment one? This is a purchase order number. Okay, 20. So what are the important columns here? PO, header, ID, and agent ID. Segment one. Segment one is nothing but what? PO number. And you will have other columns. Creation date created by vendor ID and vendor site ID. Okay, vendor ID and vendor site ID. Ship to location, bill to location. Ship to location ID and bill to location ID. So where to where we need to join, you can go through that ER diagram. Terms ID and all that we discussed, right? Currency code also there. And here, this is the status, authorization status. Okay. And type lookup code, that is to know the purchase order type. Type lookup code. And org ID, that is also very important. Org underscore ID. Okay. But generally, it won't allow to update it manually from the backend. For that, there will be another program that we have to run. Okay. So this is headers, and then go to the header lines table. PO lines all. All the PO information is in PO lines all table. So here you will have PO line ID. Again, PO header ID you will have. And item ID is there, right? This item ID, you have to take it from the MTL system items bit table. This item ID, you have to pass it to inventory item ID. Okay, and get the item description. Item description is available, but item name won't be available. The item name, you have to take it from the MTL system items B, joining with the item ID. Okay, so this is fine. Item description and all, you can get it. Unit price, everything. Straight away, you can take it. Unit price, quantity, all, you can take it. Okay. So this is PO line ID you'll have, PO header ID you'll have, item ID you can have, and description you'll have, quantity you'll have, unit price you'll have. Okay. So what is the item that we are purchasing? You can have from here. Next, there is another table called PO line locations or shipment details. So this will have all the line information. Okay, when you ship to the material, ship the material to different inventory organizations, you will have again line location ID. Line location ID and PO line ID you will have, PO header ID you will have. These are all the links. And quantity, that is shipped, quantity received you will have. Okay, quantity received, quantity accepted, all those columns are. If required, you can pull into your report, ship to location. Terms and all, you can take it from here. Now the challenge is here. PO distribution solved table. this is the place where you can get all the accounting information like ledger, code combination, all those things you can get it. So here the column is PO, distribution ID, and PO line ID, setup books ID, code combination ID, and there is a column called requisition distribution ID. If you wanted to know it quickly, you can just click here. Okay, it will open here. You can check from here also. Requisition distribution ID is there, right? This one. So why? What is that? Is requisition distribution ID. This is to know what is the requisition number for this PO. Okay, what is the requisition number for this PO? PO table is there, that's fine. And lines table is there, that is also fine. Locations is there, that's fine. Distributions is there. So from this distribution, there is a distribution ID. This distribution and line ID, setup books ID, code combination. This right, this is right. If this PO is linked with a requisition, to know from the backend what is the requisition number, this we have to join with the join to distribution ID in PO underscore requisition underscore distributions all table. Okay, this is the first step. And get the requisition line ID. Requisition line ID from this. What I am doing here, I am trying to show you how to find the requisition for a purchase order. That generally interview, they will ask this question. In any interview or most of the interviews, they will try to ask this question whenever you start explaining about purchasing tables or P2P cycle. Okay, I know I have a requisition. And based on that requisition, I created a purchase order. So now I wanted to know how to find the requisition for this particular PO. This PO is associated with which requisition? For that, your answer should be this. We have to go to PO distribution all table for that particular PO, because in this table, you will have all the other columns like PO, enter ID, PO line ID, everything you will have. That's a link between the PO table, PO header ID, and PO line table, etc. But going to the requisitions, take the requisition distribution ID column, join to distribution ID in PO requisition distribution salt table. In the PO requisition distribution, and get the requisition line ID. Next. Join requisition line ID in requisition line ID in PO underscore requisition underscore lines all and get the requisition header ID. From here we have to get the header ID. Okay, because you won't have the requisition header ID in this table, you have to go to this table, PO requisition lines. After this, third step, join requisition header ID which you captured from the headers above section to requisition header ID in PO requisition headers all table and get the segment one as requisition number. Okay, this is a relation. This is how we need to build the query. Creating purchase order from the application is very simple, but writing the queries to get the requisition number is, it's a challenge. Okay. So if it is created based on the requisition number, you can find it. If it is not there, then you will get the null value. Okay, that way also you can find whether this PO is based on the purchase, based on the requisition or not. To know that, this is the link. For example, a PO is created, and you wanted to know whether the PO is created based on the requisition or it's directly created. There are two options, right? The PO can be created directly or PO can be created based on the requisition. So if it's creating based on the requisition, then definitely there will be a requisition. But the requisition you can see from the front end, okay, the PO distributions form, but back end, this is how we have to do. You won't see directly from the back end. In any table, you won't see the requisition number directly in this. You will have the requisition distribution ID. So this ID we have to join to the PO requisition distributions or table. Join to distribution ID. This requisition distribution ID equal to distribution ID. So this will be the query to get the requisition number. If the query is, if they ask you to write the query, so they ask you to write the query, write a query to show the requisition number. Number of a purchase order. Then what you have to do? So PO, select what you need to select, segment one, right? Select PURH dot segment one. This is a requisition number. From what are the other tables we have? PO headers or PO requisition headers, all, that is PRH. And from here to here, what we join? PO lines are, PO requisition lines are. PO requisition lines all. PRL. And from PO requisition lines all to PO distribution, requisition distributions all. PRT. And from here to PO distributions all table. So these four tables where you can join here, PO headers all to this table to this table. Okay, so PRH dot requisition header ID equal to PRL dot requisition header ID. Okay, so requisition header ID to requisition header ID from this table. Then from requisition lines to requisition line ID. Line ID in PO distribution all table. And PRL dot requisition line ID to PRD, PO requisition distribution all dot requisition line ID. And PR distribution, PO equation distributions, PR dot this distribution ID. ID to PO distribution for table. PD dot distributions R. Dot requisition underscore distribution ID. Okay, so this is the query basically. Let me run this. So these are all okay. You can take one PO and check it. For example, let's take one PO. Okay, here we can put the PO number also if you want, because we are taking from the PO distribution. All dot PO header ID. sorry. Okay, so example, if I take this 221 PMO, what is our regression number? 104. So for 221, what's the segment? 511. 511 is the PO. 511 is the PO. And what is the regression number for this? You need to run this query. Can write a subquery also to get the PO number here if you want. Suppose select segment one, some PO headers all, where PO header ID equal PD dot PO header ID. That is for PO number. Say PO number also here. So for this PO, this is the regression. For this PO, this is the regression. So what I did here, from the regression headers to regression lines, I went from regression lines to regression distributions. This join you all know, PRH to PRL, PRH to PRL is a regression header ID. Regression headers to regression lines is what? Regression header ID. From regression lines to regression distribution lines table, regression line ID. Okay, so this is simple. Then after that, from here to here, what is the step? Regression distribution ID. Distribution ID to regression distribution ID. In the purchase distributions table, regression distribution ID is there. So if you refer that ER diagram of the regressions tables, you will come to know this link. This is generally they'll ask this question in any interview. So this is the query you can explain. For any PO, you can find the regression like this. So here, if you run this, and somewhere you may have no regressions also. Okay, right now we don't have the data, but there could be purchase orders without any regression also. Okay. Right now, all the POs has regressions. That's fine. You can join here regression distribution ID plus auto join, you can put here. So yeah, for this is regression, but there is no PO. That means no regression. This regression is not used in any PO like this. That is to know regressions doesn't have PO. Let's put here, PMOS doesn't have regressions. PMOS doesn't have any regressions. If we have that, this will show. Okay, so whatever the PMOS are created, all those are based on the regression. But it's not that all the regressions have a purchase order. It's not that. Whatever PMOS are there, they have regressions. But whatever the regressions have, those are all. It's not compulsory that are linked with the POs. Okay. So this is very, very important. Just you try to remember and try to use this query, practice this query. It's very simple. Regression headers to regression lines. That's a link. This is a regression header ID. Regression lines to regression distributions. Regression line ID is the link. From regression distributions to regression. This is only the new thing. And what is the link here? PO regressions, that is PRD, regression distribution ID. To in the PO table, PO distributions all table, distribution ID. So these are all the tables when the PY is created. These are all the tables will be affected. All the PY information is in this table. And these are all the columns. Okay. And lines, where you can get the PO has lines, right? Items, etc. PO line. What is the relation? PO address. Next, locations. Material has to shift to which location? PO line locations. What is the link here? PO line. For every line, there is a relation. So which location it is? And what is the accounting information? PO distribution. Here you will have the regression distribution ID, where you will see the regression number, where from where you can find the regression number. This is how we have to join same query here. Any questions or any doubts? So I recommend to create a purchase order from your site and check the tables. Okay. And you can also refer this document. Just let me show you the document, which is general notes, regular notes. Okay. So that is also I'm going to share. Creating purchase orders. So all the navigation steps I already provided. This is all for the requisition. And these are the queries which you developed yesterday, and this is for today. Purchasing business operations. So we go to purchasing business operations, search only the requisition number. Example this, click find. Click on auto create, purchase order form will be opened. Save the form. These are all the tables. Okay, columns. How to join. Lines table, columns. Line locations, columns. PO distributions, columns. Equation distribution ID. Join to the distribution ID in PO equation distribution sort table. Then join to PO line ID from PO equation distribution sort. Okay. And this is how we have to do it. The same thing what we did, right? Same. There is some task that you can develop this. Okay. In each operating unit, what are the PO's, what is the PO status, what is the type, and what is the amount? If you can develop this query, that's well and good. If you can put the requisition number, that is also very good. So and everyone should know what are the table names, what are the important columns, and what is the link between the tables. That part you need to remember. But when you enter into the technical panel, right, so they will focus on this, how strong you are in the technical side. Okay, you know how to create a purchase order, but what is happening in the back end? What are the tables affected? What are the columns? What is the join? Then only you can develop any report, any code you can develop, right? Otherwise, it's not possible. So that's what main focus is, columns, tables, all those things are very, very important. So that's all from my side. Tomorrow we'll discuss how to create purchase receipt. Okay. The flow is what? Requisition is created. Then purchase has to be created. After that, receipt. Receipt means supplier will send the material, right? For example, you are buying from a supplier, Dell. So Dell will send the material to you. So you need to receive it. That part we will be discussing in the next class. Okay. Tomorrow, if you have any questions. Okay, thank you all. Tomorrow we'll write some queries also using the PO tables. Then we'll go ahead with the next topic. Okay, so I hope it's clear to everyone. We'll discuss again tomorrow. Thank you.